A couple of weeks ago, I organized a beach volleyball tournament, and when somebody asked me who's refereeing that game, my answer was the black guy. Now, I was just trying to be quick since he was the only black amongst 20 of the friends, yet everybody around me looked at me as if I were an insensitive and a racist. You know, perhaps my approach to life is just too indulgent, or maybe it's the societal conception of indecency that is completely fucked up. This is because in 2015, oversensitive America, you're supposed to be politically correct, or PC. Well, today, I'm going to make you think about how politically correct you unconsciously are, and I'll make sure in 5 minutes you won't be anymore. Because political correctness is evil. Specifically, we're going to look at how political correctness is paradoxical, it's absurd, and unconstitutional, which ultimately leads to a threat to your future. So let's get started. As you were able to witness from my story, in 2015 America, you're not supposed to use the word black. Instead, you should say African-American, even when the person is neither African or American. Also, PC supporters will tell you that you should use words like visually impaired for blind, personal size for fat, and vertically challenged for short. But, you know, I say black, and I say blind, fat, and short, because I don't think these are insults. Look at it this way. Usually, at least I hope, you would refrain from calling a person an idiot in their face because you don't want to be rude and you know it'd be offensive. It's an insult after all. So if you feel compelled to stay away from words like fat or black, then it's because you have a problem with these words when they're merely physical attributes. Then ask yourself, who is actually racist and discriminatory? And what is actually indecent? Now you see, the paradoxical nature of political correctness leads straight into its absurdity, which is our second point. In fact, political correctness is so absurd, it's sometimes ridiculous. Like this story in the Times and NBC News of a Santa Claus being fired for yelling ho ho ho, which was perceived as derogatory and offensive to women because too similar to the American slang for whore. Or this more recent story in the UCLA newspaper, The Daily Bruin. You would think that correcting grammar mistakes on a paper would be a part of a professor's job. Yet some minority students at UCLA apparently interpreted the spelling correction as a microaggression, part of a hostile campus climate for students of color. Come on. But it gets even worse. Yul Gonen from the New York Post explains how common words have been banned from schools in New York City. Words like birthday, dance, and dinosaurs, which might offend those who don't believe in evolution. My professor of statistics here at SBCC has to call this a six-sided cube because the word die may hurt someone's feelings. I hope you guys are starting to realize that this whole PC campaign just doesn't make any sense. Now that we went over some of these absurd examples, we're ready to tackle our last point, which is political correctness is unconstitutional. In fact, if you've been paying attention so far, by now you probably should be wondering, what happened to freedom of speech? The truth is, you're right being scared. The First Amendment to the American Constitution is being threatened. The Foundation for Individual Rights in Education conducted a survey in 2013 to find that only 4% of US colleges have no restrictions to free speech, while the vast majority has some sort of politically correct speech code. Guys, this is exactly what George Orwell described in his book 1984 as newspeak, a devious form of language controlled by thought police. So if you care at all about your future, if you care about your freedom, then beware of political correctness and speak English, not newspeak. Okay, so let's remember what we talked about today. You should stop being politically correct because it's so paradoxical, it's racist, it's so absurd, it's ridiculous, and it's so against the United States Constitution that it's threatening your future freedoms. So here's the takeaway from today, guys. Let's stop pretending to conform to the guidance of decency aligned by this politically correct thought control, okay? Discern what is really indecent and plainly indulge in the freedoms that America has granted. Thank you.